Okay. Good morning, everybody. I am going to discuss about the introduction to ethology. The scientific study of animal behavior is called ethology. This term used for the first time by the 19th century French zoologist Saint Hilary. First, the term ethology. But then used with its modern meaning by the American zoologist Wheeler. So, later in 19th century, the term was used to express the lifestyle of animal. The use of term ethology in correct perspective was introduced by Nicot Inversion 1950. Anyway, ethology, it is a Greek meaning, ethos, meaning characters, habit, or convention. That means study of animal behavior is called simply ethology, study of animal behavior. Actually, it is a recent branches of zoology. Biological study, so it is the recent branches of zoology, and biological study of behavior is quite old. It first appeared in the middle of 18th century. This ethology term actually first appeared in the middle of the 18th century in the publication of the French Academy, So, the Lawrence, it is the Lawrence and the Tinbergen, they are the main founder of the ethology as well as the animal behavior. In the middle of the 20th century, the study of animal behavior became an independent scientific discipline called ethology, and mainly through the effort of mainly Lawrence and Tinbergen. So the word behavior, this is the word behavior, is used in very broad sense. So actually ethology, it is scientific, biological, and specific study of the animal. So what is behavior? So before going to discussion about the ethology or animal behavior, we should know about the behavior. What is behavior? You see, I am showing some slide. It is a body poster, you see. It is a body poster. It is running and it is walking. Here in both cases, muscles are involved. And the expression is different, is not it? Muscles are involved. Here muscles are rigidly involved. Here muscles are relaxed, is not it? And you see the expression, body expression is different in both cases, running and walking. Is not it? It is body posture. So you see, this is the facial expression of the different mood. You see, it is disgust open, it is fearful, it is fearful open. There is a difference. The facial expression is different, is not it? It is neutral open, there is also a difference. But in both cases, the expression is different, same individual. Here it is same individual, it is sad, but it is sad open. Same individual, but the expression is different. It is called facial expression. It is also a result of different behavior. Next, you see body posture. Already I have shown the figure. Next, vocalization. You see, it is dog. In a rest condition, it is normal body posture. Is that it? It is normal body posture, rest condition, all the muscles are relaxed. So it is normal. You see, same dog, their body posture is different. It is aggressive behavior. That means they attack to another. They attack. This dog is going to attack to another animal or another organism. So here body posture is different, is not it? And express as an aggressive behavior. It is aggressive behavior. You see, next slide. Here it is dog, it is also a dog, but you see, it is barking dog. That means vocalization. At that time of vocalization, actually the body posture is different, isn't it? The same dog is same, but the body posture is different in different condition. They express the actually one type of behavior. Next, you see, it is also a body posture of a dog, but it is fear. Fear, escaping behavior. That means you think that one of the another stimuli or external stimuli actually coming to attack her. So it is escaping stimuli. It is a different body posture of the dog. You see, it is nesting behavior. It is Procellus filipinus. It is bird, Procellus filipinus, and it is birds. The nesting, different birds actually. Different birds actually make their nest with a different nesting material. So, in case of Procellus filipinus, this nesting is different. You see, here it is sparrow, but it is food. It is catching. That means feeding behavior. You see, it is nesting behavior, nest making or nesting behavior. Here you see, it is food collection, isn't it? It is food collection, though it is feeding behavior. You see, it is a twig of a plant. It is a twig of a plant. But you see, it is not a twig. It is a praying mantis. It is mimicry. Actually, they mimic with that particular plant, actually. So, color is adjust with the host plant. So, it is mimicry. These are actually behavior, isn't it? So, from the above slide, it may be concluded that behavior refers to all externally recognizable senses that bring about communication and which can release behavioral pattern in other animals, isn't it? Via movements, patterns of the whole body or the portion of the body, facial expression, next body posture, vocalization, as well as changes in coloration, release of odor, etc., all are included in behavior. Okay? That means behavior generally behavior refers to the externally recognizable changes. Externally recognizable changes. But you see, there is no external sense, isn't it? He, stable, cat and pigeon, it is he, she also actually stable. So the behavior not only restricted to a movement, a one type of behavior, freeze direction. So behavior not only restricted to a movement, even the freeze reaction in a pigeon after seeing the approaching cat are also a behavior, isn't it? So freeze reaction also may be a part of a behavior actually. Freeze reaction is also a part of the behavior. You see, this is butterfly. It is male and female. It is male and female. So at the breeding season, when the gonad is matured, the female actually release some sex hormone or pheromone to the air. This female species actually release some pheromone or sex attractant to the air. These are actually volatile substance. So when this butterfly releases the odor which attract the male, actually due to the odor of the pheromone, the male is also actually attract, and after that actually this male species actually copulate with the female. So it is a part of reproduction. The release of odor, this odor actually when receive the male species of that particular species, the male is attracted to the female, and after that they perform mating and fertilization takes place. So it is the part of a reproductive behavior, and in that case, chemicals, that means chemicals means the pheromone is chemical substance. Chemicals actually play a major role in case of reproduction. Okay, so next you see why it is necessary for us to study the animal behavior. Why it is necessary for us to study the animal behavior? It is most important to study the animal behavior because you see, vast majority of people, wherever they live or whatever may their occupation and live, come in contact with animal. Even the man inhabiting in a AC room also actually come contact with the animal. So it is obvious that the hunter has to know the ways of his quarry. Otherwise, hunting cannot successful, is not it? Like that, farmer, these are the farm, cattle farming, breeding, poultry farming, piggery farming, duggery farming, fishery, sericulture, apiculture, all are actually farming. So farmer must be aware of his habit, of his farmyard animal, is not it? Cattle breeding, poultry, so piggery, duggery, fishery, apiculture, sericulture have been developed as an industry. These are actually developed as an industry for the benefits of mankind, is not it? These industries are developed for the benefits of the mankind. And these industries are actually solely depend upon the different animal. So economics actually the earning or the economic side is actually successful 100% only after understanding the behavior of respective animal. Because suppose, as for example, in poultry farmer know the all behavior of the actually sick, how much food is actually essential for their proper growth, how the light or temperature is essential for their proper growth is most essential. These are the actually behavior, like piggery also, in duggery also, how much food is essential, how much light, temperature or other factors, adaptive factors are important, they must know about the respective animal. Otherwise, this industry actually cannot successful 100%, is not it? So, you see, knowledge of behavior of creation like insects and rodents, these insects and rodents damage our crop, is not it? These insects and rodents damage our crop, vegetables. It is most notorious creature of the universe. Insects are the most notorious creature. Rodents are the most notorious creature of the universe. So even the modern city dweller have close encounter. Modern city dweller also have close encounter with the animals. They may want to ward off the cockroaches and termites. Cockroaches and termites from their houses, is not it? Or keep a dog or cat or a bird for recreation. Modern city dwellers also actually their different pets are actually reared for their recreation. So for healthy keeping of pets, their behavior must be understood. Otherwise, it is not possible to actually found the proper site. So another, you see, men also visit zoo and park to get pleasure. Men also visit zoo and park to get pleasure for observing animal. you see, lastly, we must share our world with fellow creature. And that is possible only by understanding their ecology and behavior. To ensure ecology and behavior, to ensure that animal can be preserved and managed. Animal can be preserved and managed for our future generation. At least for them to see. So you see, it is possible to understand the status of animal. It is possible to understand the status of animal. That means status of animals mean whether they are going to extinct, whether they are going to extinct or endangered. Actually, this is the status of animal. So, after study the behavior of respective animal, it is possible whether they are actually going to extinct or threatened. It is possible to know after the study of behavior of the respective animal if that particular species to going to extinct or endangered, we should preserve these animals for our future generation or conserve for our future generation. So it is actually for the above discussion, we have cleared that actually the study of animal behavior is most important for us, isn't it? So you see, why behavior is important for animal? Why behavior is important for animal? You see, each living organism adapted itself in a suitable surrounding. Each living organism adapted itself with a suitable surrounding. We also actually want to our favorable surrounding. Otherwise, we cannot exist actually. So, animal behave their benefit. So, animal behave for their benefit and survival. Main point is benefit and survival. This is the main cause why behavior is important for animal. The main cause is benefit and survival. You see, this is a culture of bacteria. If a acid drop is put at that particular place of the culture, of that medium, culture medium, actually, that they move, the bacteria of that particular area must be moved from that area to the different side of the culture, isn't it? Suppose this is a culture medium of bacteria. It is a bacteria. Bacteria is sparse here. So if you actually put a acid drop here, so in that particular region of the culture media, the bacteria must be moved from that area because it is, the acid is actually not suitable for the bacteria. So they must move from that particular place to the another place. This is flee. It is flee. Avoid acid. So they must move from the acid to the another free acid area. It is flee. You see, next, suppose it is a human and it is unwanted stimuli. So this human must be actually escape from their unwanted stimuli, isn't it? So it is unwanted stimuli, and unwanted stimuli is encountered with that particular man. This man must be escaped from the unwanted stimuli. That means flee. You see, it is actually fox. So when the hungry or thirsty, at the time of hungry or thirsty, the fox actually in search for their food, and they must move from their home to the another side for in searching food. So this is a particular behavior. It is feeding behavior, is not it? You see, this is a dancing peacock. It is a dancing peacock. The dancing is performed by the peacock at the time of breeding season. At the time of breeding season, when this peacock see a peahen, when the matured, their gonad, gonad is matured at that particular season, actually peacock perform a special dance. It is called courtship behavior. It is called courtship behavior after singing a female. And this female attract the male by just showing a courtship behavior, a particular dance. So it is, this dance is performed due to the reproduction. Is not it? You see? Suppose it is tiger and it is lion. There is a fight between tiger and lion. Why? Because you see, the tiger may be entered to the territory of the lion, or lion may be entered the territory of the actually tiger. Each organism have a actually territory. Territory means actually home range inside which the particular animal gather their food, perform their reproduction. This is territory. When another species enter in a particular area of another animal territory, there may be actually perform a fight may be performed. So this is fighting behavior, is that it? That means from the above discussion, it is clear that actually the living organism adapt itself in the suitable environment, and behind the behavior there are mainly four causes. One is feeding, another is reproduction, another is fight, and another is flee. This is the main cause behind the actually animal behavior. Feeding, to perform a feeding behavior, they must move, they must show behavior. Next, for reproduction. Next, fight and flee. These are the four reasons behind the actually behavior of animal. Next, behavior extremely important for species survival. It is a small fish. At the breeding season, it is a male sticklebass. It is a male sticklebass. At the breeding season, when the gonad is matured of the female species, this is called breeding season. At the breeding season, the male sticklebass, this is male species of a sticklebass. It is just like a trichogaster. Male sticklebass, this is a small fish. They build a tubular nest, actually. It is a tubular nest of grass and weeds. This is the tubular nest. It is built by grass or actually which on the bed of the river or the aqua body or the pond it is. After that, the female entered in that particular tubular nest. Actually, after that, the female species of the stickleback fish, the female entered into the nest and spawned in it. The male species, the next stage, the male species fertilize the egg and guards them. When the egg hatches, when the egg hatches inside the tube nest, actually, the male species guard them by swimming around the nest. Even they also penning the egg with the help of their pictorial pen, with the help of their pictorial pin. For this, the educate dissolved oxygen supply, because fresh oxygen is needed for new and born. So when they perform the penning due to the pictorial pin, educate oxygen is supplied to the nest. Even they make an extra hole actually. Even they make an extra hole or opening at the nest for the proper ventilation. Even they actually make an extra opening or hole in the nest for proper ventilation. Because ventilation means supply of oxygen, for supply of oxygen. Anyway, if the male species is removed, the eggs will die, not hatch. Because the female, after laying the egg by the female, this female come out from the nest and goes to another place. Only male is actually guarded the nest. If the male is removed, the eggs will die, not hatch. Because adequate supply of oxygen is close, another secondary animal may also attack the young one or the eggs also. So this is a simple example. This is a simple example how behavior is necessary. How behavior is necessary for survival. So anyway, so you see, it is not easy to define a behavior totally. It is not easy to define a behavior totally because different ethologists define behavior differently. It is not defined in a single definition. So you see, I am giving a slide. You see, here it is running and it is walking. So running and walking, the muscles act differently in different behavior, isn't it? So some ethologists define behavior is a symphony of muscle contraction. This is the symphony of muscle contraction guided by central nervous system. Whether they walk or whether they run, it is actually controlled by the central nervous system and it is expressed by the muscle. So behavior, another ethologist defined behavior is a response of living matter to some form of stimuli. You see, it is a behavior, isn't it? It is a play behavior. So it is stimuli, it is unwanted stimuli. So another ethologist actually defined behavior is a response of living matter to some form of stimulus. Another ethologist defined behavior includes all those processes by which an animal senses the external world and adapts itself for that environment. Again, another ethologist defined behavior is a symphony of muscle contraction that guided by central nervous system. So, anyway, I shall try to discuss the next class, the remaining part of the syllabus. Just I am giving an introductory class on the animal behavior. So,